and months and even years. Amen. But this morning, we're going to have some of our special brothers to come and share some things that God has been doing in their life. I'm going to call just two of them for about 5 minutes each, and they're going to share some of the challenges that they have been having and some of the successes they have also have had in terms of working with people and dealing with people. And this is going to involve Brother Terrence this morning. He's going to come. He's been a very faithful brother, and you can always count on Brother Terrence being on Wednesday and Sunday when he's not working. Amen. And this is going on two or three years. You can also count on him to follow up on anybody that he's assigned. We've had several people that have been impacted through his ministry, his prayers, his counsel. And he's going to come and share briefly. And after he comes, Brother Travis is going to come. And Brother Travis is going to kind of share the commitment that he has made to promote this ministry, to help, to work in certain capacities, to make this ministry be all that God wants it to be. He's going to be telling you about his commitment. Amen. And so at this time, we're going to have Brother Terrence to come first, and he's going to share as the Lord gives him. And then Brother Travis, and then Brother Wayne is going to come with something very special. He has all kind of supernatural things to share with you, how God has ministered and worked through his life. It's really amazing how God has brought Brother Wayne from way, 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 way away. Amen. God has really, we really enjoy him on Monday nights. And whenever he shares, he just really has a firm grip on the word, a really good revelation. And we really appreciate his ministry. Okay, this time, Brother Terrence is going to come. Yes, Brother Terrence is going to come. Now the children, they can just hold tight just for right now. We'll release them at a certain point. Amen. God bless you.
Praise God. It is an honor to be here this morning. Just thanking God, you know, throughout my life, where I come from and the things that I've done and where he want me to go. You know, yesterday I enjoyed being out fishing with the brothers. I was telling somebody who I met yesterday, I think it was a friend. It's been 20-something years since I've been fishing. And when I grabbed that pole, it's just like everything just came right back to me. Even though we didn't catch no fish, we might have had a little bites here and there, and the nibbles here and there, but it just felt good to be out there. And, you know, God just laid this upon my heart, you know, when he done called us for a specific purpose, reason, you know, and just sitting out there and watching people fishing, you know, waiting to catch a bite, you know, to catch something, you know. And, you know, God just laid this upon my heart about, you know, going out and being fishermen. You know, we miss some fishes and we catch some fishes, but we're not going to catch all of them. But at least we catch some. You know, and this is what the kingdom of God is all about. You know, it's catching those for those who have an ear to want to be saved or want to be delivered or want to be healed, you know, from this demonic spirit of this evil world. You know, it's just amazed me to where how, you know, someone prayed for me, you know, when I was in my foolishness and realizing what God had for me to do. And just staying on that path, you know, no matter what the obstacles are, or what I have to face everyday life, you know, God give me the strength to endure, to be more than conquerors, you know. And so, and this is what, you know, he want every church to be, is to be fishermen. You know, if it's not as the church, you can be a fisherman individually, you know. making preparation and praying and reading and asking God to direct your path and all of the stuff that the way it should go, and that's just what it's all about. He didn't give us a spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. He didn't give us to be feared out in this evil world, because the Bible says it's greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. So if you got Jesus Christ as Lord as your Savior, it doesn't matter what temptation, trials, or obstacles that you got to go through. And this is what, I'm just gonna read a scripture to you, saying how people being out in the world going about doing these things, but when God called, many are called, but few are chosen. And who is that few? And so I looked at it in Matthew when Jesus was out there looking for disciples. Everybody was out doing their own thing, working or whatever, or in sin or whatever, or trying to make a day's living, And so in Matthew chapter 4:16, it said, the people were set in darkness, saw great light, and to them which sat in the region and shadow of death, light has sprung up. From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And Jesus walked by the Sea of Galilee, saw two brethren, Simon called Peter and Andrew his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers. And he said unto them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. And they straightway left their net and followed him. And going on from thence, he saw other two brothers, James, John, brothers, in a ship, with their father, mending their nets. And he called them. And they immediately left the ships and their fathers and followed him. And when I read that scripture, I looked at, it's not all about prospering in the natural of getting things what the world has to offer, but God wants us to prosper spiritually. He wants us to prosper in ways that the world don't even see. That's why when he called us, we are peculiar people, we are royal priesthood, and people in the world cannot comprehend and don't understand about being called or being saved by God. So even though we're about to get ready to go out and evangelize, I won't be here, I'll be on vacation, but I just want to lay this upon you all, Hoss, who has the opportunity to go out and be fishermen of men, to come out as a church. Because ain't far as I'm seeing down here, and I'm not being judgmental, but I don't see churches getting out here, witness to people. I don't see it. And as us being a church, we should be able to come together, And if one could put away 1,000, two could put away 10,000, so it's just a few of us, we are the few, and I just thank God that, we are here today. Yeah. Another thing that I want to speak on, even if you're not in the church, you can still be fishermen of men, individual, right? If it's on your job, yeah, if you're dealing with family members, or you can deal with in the associates that is who you're associated with. You can still be fishermen of men, and God still will bless you and honor you. I was just sitting up here, and I was just thinking how when Jesus had his disciples, and even though that they didn't believe some of the things that he was doing, but the whole while he was just teaching them, hopefully that they will catch on, and that most of the time when we see people working in the spirit, we have a tendency to stop and just look, but all the while it's a lesson for us to grab, for us to get a hold of. You know, I was just sitting up and I was just thinking about when Jesus had to cast out a son, a father that came up to him on his knees and was asking him to cast this demonic spirit out of his son because he was a lunatic. And the disciple was right there, witness, seeing it with their own eyes. But Jesus gave them an opportunity to work in the spirit, that with the things that he done taught, and they couldn't cast them out. They couldn't cast it out. So when Jesus told them, you know, your little faith and unbelief, you know, and he just told them, you know, watch, you know, and he cast them out. You know, and that's just the same thing, because we can cast out sickness, we can cast out diseases, you know, or any demonic spirit. I'm gonna live a witness of that of myself, and my wife, she can tell you that herself, that last year when we had went out evangelizing, and they had this young girl with about 4 or 5 kids, and we went in there and we witnessed to her, but her baby was sick. But I know, you know, through my faith and through prayer and fasting and praying, that, you know, I was out to do a particular purpose, you know, is to deliver people, heal people, reaching them, receiving the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior. And so I knew in my heart that I was going to get that, Jesus was going to work through me to get that sickness out of that baby. So I anointed that baby with oil and prayed over that baby and cast out that sickness out of that baby. And lo and behold, the next day, as we did our follow-up, I think about a couple of days later, we talked to that same young lady. And she was so excited. We tried to get her here so that she could testify, you know, that, you know, what God done for that baby. You know, and so if Jesus can do it, we can do it too. It's just about our faith, just getting up and getting out of the pews and just and believing what God have us to do and getting into the Word. You know, and so I'm gonna leave you with this last scripture in John, and it was talking about the disciples. After Jesus done died, and then they realized that they had the same power. You know, Jesus told his disciple that I must go, but I will send you down a comforter. You know, he was going to send down the Holy Spirit. You know, and you're going to do much greater works than what I done.
Yes.
You know, and so as Jesus was crucified, he left. He went to his father. He left his disciples down here for to continue a great work. And this is where we stand at now, today. To be honest with you. You know, because time is still moving. You know, and so, and, you know, John 21:24 said, this is the disciples which testifies of these things and wrote these things. And we know that his testimony is true. So I'm just laying this upon your heart. If you know that the Word of God and Jesus is true, so what's stopping us? What's stopping us?
Yes.
So just as well as I'm being challenged every day when I get up, when Jesus wake me up, you know, can go on a job and deal with folks that is unsaved. Yes. It's, you know, we all have that on a job. We all do, you know, and so, you know, through it all, you know, God says never leave us and never forsake us. So I just want to lay this upon your heart for this summer, you know, and may God bless you. Amen. All right. Boy, I like that. All right. We just thank God for these people, Brother Terrence, and we're going to get around there. Here we go.